Praise the Lord. Good afternoon. This is Prophetess Kim King with your word on the go. First of all, let me say happy Father's Day to all of the men, the brothers, uncles, grandfathers, those who have been a positive role model in the life of someone else. We salute you. We honor you today. Happy Father's Day. I'm on my way out. I wanted to stop for a moment. And I was having a conversation earlier with someone, and God dropped something in my spirit about the love of God. And we know that God is love, and we know that we are to show love. But do we really understand what that love means? Unconditional love, agape love. And God was speaking to me about this love. And the thing that he brought to my attention today was Jesus loved Judas. Judas betrayed him. Judas betrayed him with a kiss for 30 pieces of silver. Yet he had love for Judas, because he went to the cross for every Judas in this world. He went to the cross for you and I, for us wretched people. Hallelujah. Thank God. He went to the cross. It was a selfless act of love. The Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So today, on Father's Day especially, we want to make sure that we're showing love to everyone, particularly those men that you know God has placed in your life, whether it's your husband, a significant other, a father, a grandfather, maybe your spiritual father, or may just be your heavenly father. But that we should show love, particularly to the men on today who are impacted and touched our lives and the lives of those around us, and for those ladies who are angry, who are bitter with men because they haven't done this or they haven't done that. And that's not to make excuses, but God still requires us to show love to one another. He who did no wrong sacrificed his life and showed love for us as he's hung on the cross. So if he can show that kind of love for us, then we too ought to be able to show love to one another. Because God loved us when we were unlovable. He loved us with all of our faults. He loved us with all of our issues. He loved us when we weren't thinking about him. He loved us when we were out in the world doing all kinds of things, and God knows what we all did. But he still loved us that over 2,000 years ago, he went to a cross. It was a deed of love. So today, God is telling us, love even those who don't love you, even those who reject you, even those who talk about you. Show them the love of God, because love covers a multitude of sin. Love will win them over. The love of God will win them over. Now, I'm not saying that we're foolish and we put ourselves, you know, in harm or you know, put ourselves in situations that cause us more damage than good. Because sometimes love means distance, and sometimes love means correction, and sometimes we have to exercise tough love. But it should be love. It should not be done out of anger. It should not be done out of revenge. It shouldn't be done in bitterness, but it should be genuine agape love. God is calling us to love, because if God didn't love us, where would we be today? My Lord, I just don't even want to think about it. So show the love of God, regardless of what people have done. God calls us to love, to show his agape love, not to judge, not to point fingers, but we ought to pray for people when they've done wrong, and just show the love of God and let God work on them. Let God deal with those who haven't done right. So that's what God spoke to me today, and how appropriate on today with the Father who is a loving Father, God who is love on today. So God, we salute our Heavenly Father. We give him glory and honor and praise today. We take time out to say we love you, Daddy. We love our Heavenly Father. Give honor to your spiritual leaders. If you have a male pastor, I pray that you have given them honor today and told them how much you appreciate them, your husband, your significant other, those men who have had impact in your lives, you know, or impacting the lives of your children. I pray that you have shown love today, and not just today. We ought to give thanks and show love to our Heavenly Father every day, and we ought to show love to one another every day, because they will know we are Christians by our love. Have a blessed day. Give God glory in all you do, and we'll see you back real soon.